Today is the Feast of Our Lady of the Rosary, where we remember our mother, our first saint, Mary, the mother of Jesus. Thanks for joining us in prayer. I'm Father Ron. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips.
And my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 133, Unity. O God, how precious it is for us, and how pleasing it must be to you when your children learn how to live and work together in unity.
It is in the measure that we do this that we begin to resemble you and to carry out more effectively your purposes in our world.
Come, let us bless his name together, rejoice in his loving concern for us, declare his worth to all creatures, and walk in obedience to his will.
The same God made heaven and earth and all who dwell here. Let us worship and serve him together.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
Happy Feast Day of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary. Today is one of the greatest feasts of all of Our Lady's feasts in the Church. Because of the grandness of Our Lady of the Rosary and this feast day, we actually dedicate the whole month of October to her. Praying the Rosary has been successful in ending plagues, ensuring victories in wars, toppling oppressive governments, providing protection from disasters, and of course, countless conversions and healings. I am a very unimportant person in the eyes of the world. I am a stay-at-home mom. I've never invented or discovered or founded anything. I honestly don't really even leave the house much. I don't have a ton of social media followers, and I actually don't even have that many friends. I used to wonder, what the heck am I even doing? What the heck am I even good for? I would see all these big, important people doing big, important things and feel all sorts of weird because when I was a little kid, I had this feeling inside that I was going to be someone big and super important one day. I remember I just couldn't stop thinking about this feeling, and I sat there reflecting on it. I was a very deep 9-year-old, and I was trying to guess what it was that God wanted me to do and what it was that was so big and important. Maybe I was going to be president, or maybe I was going to be a famous actress. The ways of the world worked their way into my soul, dirtying it and darkening it. It wasn't until a few years of living like this that I remembered that feeling. Was it possible that I could still be needed for something big? I tried many things, explored many hobbies, and I can tell you, being a mom is the most rewarding thing I could have ever chosen to do with my life. But something even more powerful happened. I started praying the Rosary every day. It was this and this alone that lifts my soul to this feeling and state of utmost importance. It was in this devotion that, for the first time, I felt it. I was doing it. I was living this important role, doing the important work heaven needed of me. The Rosary allows me, a weak and frail nobody, to become the greatest and strongest of warriors for my Jesus. With my rosary, I slay demons. I defend my family. I protect my church. I am important. I am needed. I am answering a call. Our relationship with the rosary and how we pray it will evolve, I'm sure. But if there's one thing that remains certain, it's that our world could use the rosary right now, like in a big way. Our mother needs her rosary warriors. Armies of crusaders used to pray the rosary, knowing that only with it would they be victorious. They would hang it from their belts right next to their swords. Where is our confidence in the rosary? Where are the warriors of today on fire with a faith in this devotion? Today, on the feast of Our Lady of the Rosary, I invite you to make a renewed commitment to praying her rosary. If you've never prayed it, try it out. If you pray it every now and then, try it daily. And if you pray it daily, reignite that devotion and passion for how beautiful this prayer really is and how much of an impact you're really having with it. There is no heart too hardened, no soul too stained, no body too weak to be bound to our Mama through this prayer. I invite you to join me today in being a rosary warrior. Because you are important and you are needed. Mama Mary, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary, pray for us.
And normally here we pray our Father, but because it is our Feast of Our Lady of the Rosary, in honor of our Blessed Mother, now we pray her prayer, the Hail Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Let us pray. God our Father, you gave us Mary not only as the mother of your Son, but also ours. May we turn to her in our need and intercession, that we might grow in the love that she experienced and shared with Jesus, and so together find a place that is home with you. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you for being with us. Mary, protect us, watch over us. And now may the blessing of Almighty God be with you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. We'll see you tomorrow.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour